glad to have you with us in the studio. I'm Reese Davis, bringing you the EA Sports NCAA Football 14 pregame show presented by Nissan. Innovation that excites. This showdown between these two teams has been looming for quite some time. Both know the conference championship is at stake, and for the loser, that team is likely to take a major hit in its postseason bowl plans. That does it for us here on the NCAA College Football Pregame Show. Enjoy the game. We'll see you at the half.
Military post in America becomes the scene as we prepare for what should be a football war. And now let's head down to the coin toss. Brought to you by Coke Zero. Real Coca-Cola taste and zero calories. Enjoy everything. Army is getting fired up down there as they get ready to boot this opening kickoff. He'll return this one from the 7. He's got the corner. And he's tackled at the 46-yard line.
Hey, that's a pretty good return there to open this game up.
So let's see what the offense can do as they come out onto the field. Scrambling. And he's tackled right around the 30.
Good job by the offensive line to pick up the linebacker on the blitz. That gave the quarterback enough time to find his man for a nice game.
It's first and 10. Ball on the 30. Tries to get around the corner. Makes it to the 21.
That's good for a gain of 9 yards. That brings up second and 1.
Let's pick it up. It's our time, guys. Our time. Let's get off the field. Let's get off the field.
Bring it in. My God.
Tackle made at the 20-yard line. So the running back comes away with a short gain on the play, and he also gets a first down.
They only needed a yard, and the tailback was able to get it.
From the 20-yard line, first down. Right gets a carry left side. He's taken down at the 12.
That's a gain of 8 on the play. That makes it second and 2.
Down he goes, right around the 12-yard line. So it's third down, and they've got about 2 yards to go. He's tackled at the 2.
This is the kind of steady, strong drive the coaches love to see. Right now, they're firing on all cylinders.
And he tacks on the extra point. It was a 7-play, 52-yard drive, and a touchdown as a result.
Boy, this offense right now is just being physical, really controlling the line of scrimmage, and it's opening up some nice big lanes for the running back.
Everyone's all lined up and ready for the kickoff. Keller from the 4, tackle made at the 29. quarterback leads the team out on the field for the first drive. Around the 43-yard line. The Black Knights have a lot at stake here, including some possible record-breaking performances. Records and stats are great, but I think to a man, these players say, let's win the game first, and then any accolades we get along with it, that'd be great. He laterals the ball. He makes it out to maybe the 46-yard line.
That's a gain of 3 on the play. That'll make it 77.
They get nice yardage on that run.
Gain of 4 yards. That makes it 3rd and 3.
Makes it out to about the 29.
Play here and run support by the linebacker. The big guys up front took away the running lanes, and he was able to get through for a loss.
So it's 2nd and 14. Ball on the 34-yard line. Passes to the back, incomplete.
I love to see a confident quarterback, but you don't want to just go back there and put blind faith in your throws. You need a little bit more time to evaluate the coverage before you release the football.
Wants to throw outside. And he tackles him hard at the 9.
It definitely put them in better field position. And I just have a feeling that they're going to punch it into the end zone on this drive.
To the fullback, they can't hook up. Incomplete. It's the 9th play of the drive. And they'll bring him down behind the line.
That is a loss of 3 yards. That makes it 3rd and goal.
From the 13-yard line, 3rd down.
Let's go, let's go. Here we got Mike, number 53. Mike 53.
Fires quick after the receiver, and he can't make the grab.
That was textbook coverage by the defense. That's exactly what you want to do on every single pass play, but it doesn't always happen.
The kick is up, and they tack on 3 points.
And you got to think they're pretty happy with holding them to a field goal right there.
Looks like they're ready for the kick. He's to the 20. And down he goes at the 33. And offense is back on the field after running the ball very well on their last drive.
This offensive line really opened up some big gaps for the running back last time.
Throws it in a hurry. And they make the stop at about the 37-yard line.
That brings them 2nd and 5.
From their own 37-yard line, 2nd down. Connecticut is up 4. Fights forward to about the 39. He wants it all, going long. He hauls it in. He's brought down in the open field.
First down.
So after the big pass play, we've got a first down. Four-yard line. So at the end of one, UConn leads it 7-3. Back to the action now here in the second quarter. And he's level at the 15.
Makes it first and 10.
From the 15-yard line, it's first down. And now he's got room to run. Touchdown, Connecticut. Coordinator.
Big time play, taking that ball all the way in. Maybe the defense wasn't expecting a run.
And he converts the extra point. The kicker looks like he's ready to kick this one off. From the six, brought down at the 31. You think about the challenges these two teams are facing. On one side, you've got to find a way to keep building on your lead, and on the other side, you've got to find a way to get back in it. Now he pitches it. Army's got a guy behind center that can really do it all, Herbie. I mean, he's a dual threat. He can hurt you with his feet and his arm. With this guy, it's PYP. Pick your poison. Third down, six to go. Ball on their own 35. Halfback's got it on the quick throw. That's a great tackle at the 32-yard line.
That'll bring up fourth and nine.
Watts is back deep to return the punt. He's taken down at the 43-yard line. It was a pretty one-sided first quarter, but I wouldn't be surprised if things changed in a big way before halftime. They'll bring him down right around the 44-yard line. From the 44-yard line. First down. And he hits him hard at the 27.
Getting after that quarterback, and right now I think they've got in with some happy feet. He appears to be a bit rattled.
From the 27-yard line, it's second down. And he can't get away from the pressure. set up a little screen, gets it to his tailback. And he's taken down right around the 20.
That was a well-designed and executed pattern, but on third down and forever, it just wasn't enough.
It's fourth down. They'll line it up for the field goal. He gets it up, and he's got it. Connecticut ready to kick this one off. Take it at the 5. They'll bring him down at the 30. The quarterback leads the offense back out onto the field as we get set to resume play.
Sure, it's disappointing, but this is the kind of mechanical flaw you can fix with practice and coaching.
From their own 30-yard line, second down. He's going to try and scramble. And he's tackled right around the 38-yard line. Gets out to about the 38-yard line. And they just stuffed that one.
Hey, this is a great play here by the defense to bring him down before he can get to the sticks.
These special teams have done it before, blocking punts. It looks like they're coming after this one. He's got the corner. Watts takes it at the 32. They bring him down, and they bring him down hard on that one. The Huskies are sitting pretty now after getting off to that slow start at the beginning.
Yeah, things were a little sluggish early, but my gosh, these last few series, they just seem to be, at this point, just kind of setting a tone and kind of having their way against this defense.
So now both teams come trotting back out onto the field. Here's a screen pass, gets it to the back, and he is drilled at the 49-yard line. That's good for him. They're about 4 yards away here on second down. Very good tackle in space.
Makes it first and 10.
Let's go! Line 80!
He fires left side. He almost had it, but it's incomplete.
It can be tough making a play on the ball sometimes, but that's probably a pick he should have made.
Second down and 10 to go. Ball on the 43-yard line. Tackled after positive yardage. Around 5 yards on the delayed handoff. The Huskies call a timeout. That's their second of the half.
Ready, lighting,
pulls it in, and he's in the open field. And they push him out at the 30-yard line.
Boy, this guy really showed some giddy up getting down the field for a big game. First down.
From the 30-yard line, first down. The catch. First down.
Here we go.
And he carries the ball for a nice game. Throws quick to the receiver and it falls incomplete. And so it's another third down upcoming here. Shot to the tight end, and he can't pull it in.
Fourth
backs away, and it's through the uprights.
And it looks like they're ready for the kickoff. From the 5-yard line, across the 30, tackled at the 35-yard line. It's still only the second quarter. We've got a lot of football left, but I've got to say, this one is teetering on the brink of a blowout. Here they come, and he's going to come up with a sack. It looks like the defensive end that got in there.
Yes, it was. He did a wonderful job of fighting off blocks to bring the quarterback down.
So it's second and 12. Ball on their own 33. And here's a quick throw. This one will fall incomplete.
Man, I don't know if this quarterback misread the defense or just made a poor decision, but that wasn't a pass he should have thrown. Before the game, and I have to say, they look sharp before this one even started.
Let's see if a quarterback heaves it up there and one of his guys can come down with it. He heaves it deep. We've reached halftime, and I don't think too many people were expecting this. 20-3, UConn.
We've played 30 minutes. Glad to have you with us on the EA Sports NCAA Football 14 Halftime Show, presented by Nissan. Innovation that excites. David Pollack and I here in the studio to break down everything that just happened in your game. So far, so good for both offenses in terms of taking care of the football, but now the defenses are ramping up the sense of urgency in terms of trying to get the ball back from their offense.
Absolutely. You got to find Reese. These ball hawks on defense, they need to find the football. They need to make some big plays, create some turnovers. How about using that hit stick a little bit? How about knocking somebody silly and making them drop the football? I mean, defense's number one priority is trying to turn the football over, try to make a big explosive play for your offense so they can do more damage and they can take the ball down the field. So those ball hawks need to show themselves in the second half.
We've done what we can do here at halftime. Time to get you back out to the second half. We'll keep an eye on everything going on in college football. Brad Nessler and Kirk Herbstreit ready with a call.
And we welcome you back to the action here, just about set for the second half. He really got a hold of that kick. He's to the 20. He makes it out to maybe the 23-yard line. The Huskies continue to get it done on the defensive side of the football, Kirk.
Yeah, they've done a good job of building this lead and almost determined here to protect it. Let's see if they can hold on here for the rest of the way.
There's got to be some sense of urgency to this offense right now. They don't have the luxury of wasting drives if they want to get back in the game. Taken down at the 20-yard line.
That's a gain of 3 on the play. That'll make it 2nd and 7.
From the 20-yard line, it's 2nd down. Tackle around the 20-yard line.
No gain on the play. That makes it 3rd and 7.
Zips it to the back, and down he goes at the 18.
Mirroring on the tackle at the 18-yard line. Fourth down.
Let's go, let's go. And we got Mike, number 53. Mike, 53. And here's the line.
He scrambled. He's tackled at the 17-yard line. Their They're set to go for another round. Gains his way to the 30-yard line.
That's good for a gain of 13 yards. First down.
It's first and 10. Ball on the 30. They make the stop around the 41-yard line.
First down.
The Black Knights lost a player earlier, and Herbie, this is a big blow to this team. Doesn't look like he's going to play any more football today. And they get him in the backfield for a loss. From their own 40-yard line. Second down.
Hold this.
Set, fire, huh?
Here comes the pressure. Up down at the 39. First and 10. Ball on the 39.
Three down. New Mike 52. Set. Green 95. Green 95.
They'll bring him down around the 18-yard line.
That's good for a gain of 21 yards. First down.
We've got a first and 10. Ball on the 18.
Let's go!
Nice run, and he's brought down.
That'll bring up second and 3.
Well, that's another first down, Brad. That's the fifth first down on this drive. You know, this offense isn't hitting a lot of big plays, but they're very, very consistent with their execution. It's putting a lot of pressure right now on this defense.
Fullback run, and he stopped in the backfield. It's the ninth play of the drive. They'll spread the field here. Let's see what the defense does with a five wide out. Quick strike, and he drops it. So here we go. It's third and goal from the 2-yard line. And the goal line defense digging in here. And he has it on the corner. Touchdown, UConn.
Kid is a really reliable weapon. You definitely want the football in his hands near the end zone, and he showed you why right there.
He makes the PAT. Everyone's all lined up and ready for the kickoff. Excellent kick. He's to the 20, and he's taken down at the 23-yard line. There's got to be some sense of urgency to this offense right now. They don't have the luxury of wasting drives if they want to get back in the game. He's on the run, and he's taken down at the 39-yard line. He's
scrambling. And they get the sack.
The protection broke down. The defense was in the backfield in a hurry, and they brought the quarterback down. Nice play.
From their own 38-yard line, second down. The 42. Now he tries to buy some time. He's at the 30. Tackle made at the 28-yard line.
This is the kind of steady, strong drive that coaches love to see. Right now, they're firing on all cylinders.
Scrambling. Knocked out of bounds at the 10-yard line. Throw to the fullback. They can't hook up. Incomplete. And this play is number 8 on the drive. Right, running back's got it. He gets hit out of bounds at the 1-yard line.
Situation.
Defense stacked in tight here. They don't get it. Here's an update from the studio and Reese Davis.
The cauldron of intensity that is the SEC championship game.
The Razorbacks
continuing to pound the rock on the ground and score a touchdown. The Razorbacks on top, 24-21.
And for the Black Knights, well, you have to think that that score is going to put a lot more pressure on them today. Watts, Army ready to kick this one off. He's to the 20. Brought down at the 29-yard line. The Black Knights have simply rocked the college football world with an astounding effort in this one.
This is one of the biggest upsets I think we've seen all year. You know what's great? They didn't worry about any of the outside distractions. They just kind of locked in to themselves and their coaches, getting ready for this football game, and it's really paid off for them.
They'll bring him down for a loss on the play. Loss of 5 there.
That play was sort of out of sync from the start, but you have to also recognize that the defense made a great play. They read it from the get-go.
We've played 3, and this is not what the experts predicted. The Huskies with an 18-point cushion. In this very pivotal fourth quarter.
Four down.
Mike, 55. Right there, 55.
Ready, green 90.
And he hits him hard at the 16-yard line. So the sack makes this third and very long. And he's going to be sacked for a loss. Keller, the return man. Keller fields it to 44. He makes it to the 35-yard line. Army's been doing special things on offense all season long, and not today. That's not what we've been expecting.
This has been a shocker. These guys have had their way with almost every defense all year long. You come in expecting the same thing, and they lay an egg. Oh, I didn't expect to see this at all.
We're about set to start things up again.
Set, check, check. Eight.
He's going to try and scramble. Dives for extra yardage. Complete pass. It's third down, and they're about 2 yards shy of the sticks. Taken down around the 1 yard line. Allen picks up around 3 on the option to the fullback.
That brings him second and goal.
This is what an offensive lineman hopes for, an opportunity to impose his will on the defense.
So the offense is going to go for 2. Got to be careful of a pass play with this defense. Pitch out, got the corner. They got it. So with just over 3 minutes remaining in the fourth quarter, the score is 27-17, UConn. At the 42-yard line, the Black Knights came in here with a nationally ranked defense. They haven't looked like a nationally ranked defense to me.
Brad, I don't think they're playing with their normal focus that we've seen from this team. We've seen backs at times that are breaking open. Wide receivers are making plays over the top of defensive backs. They're just not as dialed in as they normally are.
Both teams are well aware that a score on this drive is going to create an almost insurmountable lead. This defense has really got to step it up and make a stop. And they got him for a loss. Second down, about 12 yards to go. Ball on the 43. Less than 3 minutes in the game.
Here we go.
Nice run there. Right. Gains about 5 yards on the run. Give to the tailback. And he carries the ball for a nice game. And he didn't get enough for the first.
Now, Brad, he's going to come up short here. The defense does a nice job of not allowing the ball carrier to get out into the open.
And it's the offense that takes the field on fourth down. Watch out for a pass play when you're in a goal line D. He makes it out to maybe the 29-yard line. So the running back comes away with a short gain on the play, and he also gets a first down.
Well, the defense closed in on him pretty quickly, but not before he picked up just enough yards for the first.
Nice run up the middle. Wright picks up about 4 yards on the play. Army will use their final timeout. From the 25-yard line, it's second down. Makes it to the 22-yard line. And the halfback carries for a pickup of 3.
That makes us 3-3.
Sheds a tackler. Runs outside for a nice gain.
That's good for a gain of 7 yards.
First down. And this is the 8th play of the drive. Under a minute left in the game. Nothing more demoralizing for a defense than seeing the opposing quarterback take a knee. Should do it. Our final tally of this one, 27-17, UConn. So, Kirk, how would you sum up the action of this one?
I thought if they played a really good game that they might be able to keep it close. But I'll admit it, I never gave them much of a shot at winning. Did they ever prove me and a lot of other people wrong? Connecticut could have easily rolled over today, but instead they came out fighting and played a fantastic game for a really hard-earned win.
Huskies, they'll notch their 11th win in what has been an excellent season. And for Army, the loss today puts them at 11-2 for the season.